Greetings, Pilgrims. This is Wretch. Welcome back to Samurai Warriors 4-2. Now that the friendship between Yoshisugu and Mitsunari has been cemented, now we move on to the signs of greatness. Kojūrō Katakura serves as the cutting edge of the Date spear. The story of his loyalty to his master Masamune Date is about to unfold. I really like both of these characters, so this should be fun. This is another story about a very, very loyal retainer that, quite frankly, helped fill a void that the Lord had. Masamune, I don't think, could have been as great as he was without Kojūrō there. Just like other lords couldn't, like Ieyasu, couldn't be what he was without Honda there. The retainers were so important to the success. Masamune's debut. The One-Eyed Dragon has risen. Use all of the strategic acumen at your disposal to bring glory to your lord's first campaign. I'm really liking this because now we're starting to kind of go away from central Japan into the northern and southern regions, so we'll get some new battles going. And obviously it'll just be Kojūrō and Masamune, I would imagine. Unless we get Maigoichi and Keiji. It's a loyalty test. And goes right back. That's your boss. I love Masamune's armor. Very proper. Oda Nobunaga ga jōrak shi, jūgō de ha o tonaete ita koro, Ōshio de hitori no wakamono ga genpuku shita. Date Tōjirō Masamune, minami ōgu o osamete ita, Date Terumune no chakunan de aru. Terumune wa Mutsu no haken o megiri. And we saw that death scene in Samurai Warriors 4. The hostage situation where Masamune had to have his own father gunned down. But it looks like these are happier times. Terumune is still alive, and it looks like we get to ride side by side with him. Oh, Mr. Flintlock. Oh, hey, Maigoichi. Speaking of Flintlock. Well, as much as I like Maigoichi, I think we're going to go ahead and stick with those two, because the thing about Maigoichi, he doesn't stick around for very long. Okay, cool. It is just the classics. So, Kojūrō is special skill, Masamune is hyper, so that didn't change from Samurai Warriors 4. We got 2200. Fortunately, we don't have to worry about upgrading any weapons right now, so let's focus on the tomes. We can get everything but the specials. That's good. Now, if this is Kojiro's story, let's go ahead and focus on him. It looks like he starts all speed. Everything else here is level 10 and 20 acquisitions. Speed boost. I figure Masamune would be like that too. Let's check first so we're not... Oh, he's all defense and... That's strange for a hyper character. I guess that would make him really powerful really quick. We got one more speed. And now we go into the attack. I think we may have maxed him out. Yep, nothing else that we can do for him until he reaches level 10. I like that. Now, Masamune, Lord Date himself. What we got here? Really? And that's it for Masamune until he hits level 10. Weird. Alright, well that lets us save up some tomes at least. I like the sword and shield combo that Kojūrō has. Need to upgrade the horses eventually, but it is not this day. Ebony Wing will have to do. So it looks like Kojūrō's in the southwest with Masamune in the southeast. That looks beautiful. I'm looking forward to this. Something new. That water doesn't look very sanitary though. Maybe it's a hot spring. Drive out the Soma. I can do that. Oh yeah, I forgot he has a pistol. He carries it as a sidearm. But that's all about the Date. The Date is are all about the firearms. And shoot in midair. Defeat Tanayuki and Tanakiyo. I'm on it. We can afford to be weak during this first battle. With both of them, we have no super characters. We got spoiled with Mitsunari. And friends. Okay, that's one objective cleared. Let's switch over to the boss. And we got some spearmen. That's going to make life fun. Defeat Tanemasa and Taniaki. And Avalanche. So we gotta go this way. Ow, ow, ow. Stop it. Imbeciles. You don't know who you're messing with. Right into a finisher. Oh. Shoots the gun and walks away. Okay, Kojūrō, we're just going to flip-flop here. And switching right there was bad timing. Going to grab this weapon. And who we got here? Out in the open. Lure him out of the central garrison and defeat him. Alrighty. Masamune's like, beat all the garrisons. All the garrison captains gotta die. Don't need... The path is shut over there, wasn't it? Oh, no, it's not. Okay, I see. Maybe that cleared the avalanche. Hey, Masamune. Sorry. Despite the fact you're the Lord, we're not going to double up on the horse. So what's the storyline? Oh, okay, he just couldn't see out of that eye, so he figured he didn't need it. That's perfect logic. Ooh. Right around this mountain pass, that was a steep drop. I don't remember fighting this battle ever. So this is something at least that's been altered, which is cool. Alright, Masamune, let's go ahead and lead this guy out. Hello. Now we can take you out. Gotta make sure that you are out of that fort. No, Kojūrō, do not knock him back in there. We've got stuff to do. There we are. Level increase for Masamune. Masakage is pleased. Now we got standard bearers to deal with. Let's go ahead and make this part of the battlefield a little bit easier to swallow. Over here, too, while we're at it, now that the gates have opened. Excuse me, guys. I'll deal with you here in 1 second. And there's Magoichi, so he's fighting against us at the moment. Alright, we're good now. That is like one of the greatest finishers. Oh, that's a great finisher too, guys. Psycho mercenaries. Defeat Mokoruku Saika and Morishige Tsuchibashi. I'm sorry if I butchered that pronunciation. Let's just run through here. And we got enough for an ultimate Musu. Let's see what we got here. I'll take it. Kill all the things. Now. Oh! Say goodbye to all those riflemen. Hey! Not going to be fond of that. He may be riding out here soon. Show them the firepower of the Saika. Well, that's not really firepower. That's more like snow power. Now, Tene Okada. Soma army morale decreased. That's good. So far, so good. We got two enemy officers heading straight for us. Defeat Kiyotada Nakamura and Tanishige Musagai. Got an ultimate Musu here. I might as well use it. Hey! Several Soma army reinforcements have appeared. Awesome. Good. More meat for the grinder. Now, if I remember, his is a spin attack, I think. Oh no, he just rains down the death. Never mind. I was mistaken. Let's get a weapon for Masamune. Now, is that everything here? I think so. Let's go have Kojūrō take out one of the reinforcements who just showed up. So help me if we have to fight a Wampa in these ice caves. So I also found out that, oh, I was gonna go for finisher, but Masamune knocked us out of... knocked him out of setup. Kojiro's glasses are purely cosmetic. He doesn't actually need them. Sadotane Soma and Takatane Soma. I figured he was just nearsighted. It was kind of an interesting difference with Masamune having one eye and him needing glasses, but apparently he does not need the glasses. I guess it leads his enemies into a false sense of security. Like, I guess underestimating him because he has glasses, thinking he's nearsighted when he's actually very, very farsighted. Shoot him up in the air. Now, while Date's taking care of that and ignoring the standard bearer, which he really should do, let's go ahead and have him do that real quick. There we go. We'll take care of these guys. Hello? Over here, please. I have such things to show you. With my awesome anime character glasses. Well, they were too far away for an effective range, but it did take the lion's share. Oh, I got Psycho Mercenaries right here. You guys all go away. Okay, there's one. And two. Got a saddle and some tomes. Not bad. Looks like Masamune did what he needed to do. Let's grab whatever he dropped. Oh, standard bear is still there. Never mind. He was not able to complete his task. It just we beat the crap out of them and their morale dropped anyway. No worries. Out of the way, Pex! Oh! Yoshishige Satake. He just showed up. Nope, you guys thought you were gonna be all tricksy. That is not how we work. Prevent them from approaching Teramune. We will keep you from dear old dad. Let's see what a normal Musu does. Nah. Good old gunfighter. And a fire spin, as befitting a dragon. Even of the one-eye variety. Kojūrō is struggling. Nah, he's fine. Another one bites the dust. Okay, Kojūrō. Who are you fighting? Soma? Satotane? Probably should get some food before taking on Magoichi. He can cleave through health pretty good if he's able to get a decent combo of it. Oh, never mind. Don't have to. Now Takatane, we will save our ultimate Musus. Juggle you up. Alright, so they're done. Everything's going pretty much as planned. Oh. Okay, gates are about to open. Opportunity knocks. So Magoichi actually might be the big baddie of this battle. Alright, gates are opening. Weapons are becoming available. Now. Oh lord. Oh lord. That's a bad part of town to be in. Here, have this. Bells, bells. All right, Kojūrō. Oh, right into a Musu. Masamune. Let's finish off our favorite mercenary. Oh, he's getting, point blank. There we go. I think that was a pretty stellar first impression by the one-eyed dragon and his four-eyed companion. We need to get a good name for Kojūrō. If Date's the one-eyed dragon, Kojūrō should be the four-eyed what? You know, the four-eyed Oni or something cool. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think Kojūrō's nickname should be. Fresh reinforcements. We got everything but one locked for almost 27,000. New normal, what's your special? After effects caused by balls of energy released when attacking, strengthen your blocks. You encounter with a shield attack while blocking. Nice. Level 8 for both of them. And what we get here? Firebird shield. Oh, the four-eyed firebird. That would work. Or the four-eyed phoenix. Iron fan. Level potential of 20 for Masamune. That's good. So we got some upgrades here. No attack tomes, but plenty of defense tomes. Now we're needing speed tomes in a really potent way. Making amends.
Kojūrō, kotabi no ikusa wa migoto de atta. Daga, amari joushi ni noranu koto da. Kokoroete orimasu, Munetoki-sama. Furui katakata no yakuari o ubao nado to, mouto o kangaete orimasen. Sono onoi ga sukan no da!
What a couple of pricks. That's right. At least Masamune realizes that he is not the brightest when it comes to intellect. He did ask you. Well, Masamune seems to like Kojūrō, but the rest of the group, not so much. And we'll move on to the conflict at Koriyama in the next episode, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you liked the episode, go ahead and click like down below, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, that'd be a big help, and we'll see you next time. Later days, everyone.